There's one problem with renovating travel trailers, and that is that it seems to be a never-ending thing. And this is maybe why you don't want to renovate your travel trailer. Just go buy one. This is my 2006 FEMA travel trailer, which I renovated. I've got a video on it, about 27,000 views. Go take a look if you'd like. Please make sure you watch the entire video. I do address the formaldehyde issue. So before you go make a stupid statement and post it up there for everybody to see so you look really stupid, watch the whole video. I do address the problem. If you're going to do a renovation, I highly recommend get out your phone and take pictures of everything you disassemble so you'll have something to reference, and take more pictures than you think you'll need. You'll be amazed at how you'll look back at something 6 months later and go, how did that go together? Originally, I put in an office refrigerator. This was great for staying at KOA campgrounds, other campgrounds, stuff like that. Running the generator, that was fine, except it was a little noisy. I do have a solar power system that I ran it off from, and that was fine, but it just was kind of an inconvenience. So one of the first things that I've decided to do was replace the fridge. I found a replacement fridge for a very reasonable price, an RV fridge, which is propane and 120 volt. So the first thing I had to do was cut the vent holes in my trailer for the lower half and upper half of the fridge. These fridges create a lot of heat, and you have to allow that to escape. The vent happened to take the place of right where my outdoor light was, so I had to replace that, and I put LEDs on the vent itself, and that seems to be working. The vents can be found on Amazon or any RV place. They're just Dometic vents, and they come with the instructions on how to put them into the wall and all that, so that was a piece of cake. One of the problems with renovations, the trailer's unusable, as obvious by this huge mess here. That's the fridge on the left. You can barely see it. I had to actually remove the entire box that I had built for the RV or for the office fridge and completely rebuild this thing to where this RV fridge would slide in and have plenty of room to do what it needs to do, you know, operate. And it wasn't, it's a two-part thing, and I'll explain that here. Since an RV fridge uses propane, the back portion of it gets very hot, and you have to almost have a flue or chimney where heat rises, pulls from the bottom. That's why the vent's at the bottom, and then exits at the top. Now, it's not super hot, but it's still hot. So you want to protect that area as much as you can. So it kind of builds two chambers. The back chamber is for where the heat rises up, and then the front portion is where the fridge actually is. In that back portion, I used a insulation that's typically used inside of automobile doors or underneath the hood of a car. Very high temperature, it doesn't burn, and it channels all that heat very nicely. And it's on all sides of that back chamber area, so it protects the wood and everything. In a lot of RVs, the wood is exposed and in that area, and I just didn't like that idea, so that's why I put this foam and metal insulation in there. The insulation's great. It's got a peel back on it, and then it sticks like glue to the walls. So I did use a few tacks to hold it in place or staples, but it's really not necessary. This stuff just stuck to everything, including my hands. So following the instructions with the refrigerator, I mounted it and got it in there nicely and put all my switches and everything back on the sidewall where they had originally been. So I tested both on 120 volt and on propane, and it works fine. I love the fridge. It's 9 cubic foot, so it's plenty large enough. And then I went ahead and rebuilt the cabinets that I originally had on the small fridge around it, and it actually came out pretty nice. Now, I still have to create or build some panels for the front. I'm not going to buy them because they're outrageous. I'll just build something to cover that silver on the fridge itself and be done with that part of the project. But am I done renovating? No, of course not. There's 8 T105RE Trojan batteries. They're 65 pounds a piece that I used to have to load up in my truck, haul up to wherever I was going along with the trailer, unload them, connect them all up, hook them up to the power inverter and the solar panels and all that. And that just got to be crazy. So I instead opted for some lithium ion batteries and to build them inside and put all that stuff inside. I also mounted four high-power solar panels, two 305-watt and two 285-watt, on top of the trailer to power these lithium-ion batteries. And that way I don't have to unload or load anything anymore. So again, the ripping and tearing apart continues with deciding where to put the lithium batteries and also ripping out all of the electrical for the power inverter, the solar panels, all that stuff, and piling it up, getting ready for a new place for it to go. The solar panels are set up in parallel of the 305s and parallel of the 285s. That way I have two arrays that I can work with if one goes down. And also I've got two 40-amp charge controllers and a 6,000, 3,000, 6,000-watt pure sine wave inverter. I also have a 1,500 as a backup. I always believe in redundancy here. And it seems to work out pretty good. So far I've had no problems with any of the equipment. The batteries are 4P batteries, so that means that they're about 16 volts, a little high. Actually, my inverter will take up to 16 volts, and then it shuts off. So I actually run these a little bit lower than the maximum capacity. It also helps to extend their life, so I'll run them down to about 25% of capacity and then charge them up to about 20% of full capacity, and that extends their life. These came out of a conglomerate, a combination of two auto manufacturers. I believe one was Volkswagen, and they were off of eBay. Don't remember the name of the company. If you're interested, let me know and I'll be glad to post that up here. But I got them for a fairly reasonable price, a lot cheaper than you can buy the standard 12-volt lithium batteries for, which the last one I bought was $700, which was crazy. What I really liked is that they fit into my cabinet that was already in the trailer that I had built almost perfectly. They are screwed down, as well as there's boards holding them in place, so they're not going anywhere. Now, down at the other end of the lithium batteries, I had already mounted the pure sine wave inverter and the charge controllers for the solar panels and batteries in the trailer, but I had to remount them because these took a little bit different approach as to how the wiring goes and all that compared to how I had it with the external lead acid Trojan batteries. So I cleaned up the area after removing all the electronics and all that good stuff, and went ahead and put a board up and bolted that in, and then started mounting all of the equipment. And it went in pretty nicely. I did have to do some adjustments, but and there are some tight areas, but they're not bad. One of the problems I made was I originally put the shunt that goes to one of my meters on the positive leg of the battery and the power inverter, and that was the wrong side. It needed to go on the negative side, so I had to do a little rewiring and rerouting, but all in all, it still came out. That was minor. It came out pretty good. This shows the corrected wiring. The shunt is now down at the bottom on the negative leg where it's supposed to be, and the positive then just goes straight up through the switch, through the 250 amp fuse, and then into the inverter. The solar panels are both switched. The solar charge controllers are both switched and have 40-amp fuses on them. And the power to the battery and between the battery and the charge, or the pure sine wave inverter, are also switched. And it has a 250-amp fuse on it for protection. With that all connected up, I went ahead and fired up the batteries, turned them on, and Viola, I have power. Now, the total amp hours out of the lithium ions are not as much as the Trojan batteries, but I also am not running a refrigerator off from it anymore, since the refrigerator runs off of liquid propane. So that cuts my usage way down and should help those batteries to last plenty long enough. This picture is the meter that needed the shunt, and sorry for it being a little blurry. You can see it's over 15 volts, and right now I used the charge controllers and the solar panels yesterday to charge the batteries up to what I've got as capacity is 15.8 volts, and I'm discharging them down to 14.7, which is about their nominal voltage. Lithiums like to be left at a 50% charge, so that's a good place to leave them. Don't leave them fully charged, and definitely don't leave them drained. So it's very important if you're planning to go with lithium, do a lot of reading on them. They're definitely handled different than lead acid batteries. Here I've got the charge controllers off, and like I said, I'm dropping the battery's voltage, getting them down to that nominal level, so I can put them in storage or keep them in a storage state. I do plan to use them in a month, but right now they need to be at that 50% charge level. Now, for those that think that stuffing this into a cabinet's a bad idea because of lack of ventilation, you're absolutely right. So on the top of the counter above where this stuff is stuffed, I cut out an opening and put a grate across it so that it allows circulation. So two major updates to the trailer, and it looks pretty good now that I've got it cleaned up and everything in place and everything's working again. And that allows me to go up to my ranch in Colorado and enjoy being off the grid and not having to worry about running a generator for a fridge or anything like that. And like I said, these renovations, they just keep going. I don't know what's next, but I'm sure there's going to be something shortly. I'm not sure what's up with my phone doing these blurry pictures. Sorry about that, but I hope you like this and enjoyed seeing the changes. It was a lot of fun. I do enjoy doing this stuff, and it's not that hard if you really just do your research. So, again, if you liked it, go ahead and click the like button and subscribe. And if you got questions, be more than happy to answer any. Derogatory stuff, I just delete, so don't even bother. But if you're really interested in learning about this stuff, plenty of information out there on the net. Thanks again. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye.